What's a NAS? How do I set one up? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Remember to sign up for my weekly newsletter, Confident Computing. Every week I give you tips, tricks, and more advice on how to use your technology with more confidence. Newsletter.askleo.com gets you to the sign-up form. So here's the question I got. I've been reading about NAS devices lately. I like the idea of using one and would like to deploy one on my network. I have an external drive that I would like to convert to a NAS device. I was wondering if this was possible to do or not. Would I have to buy a NAS enclosure or something else? NAS is a wonderfully generic term that really just stands for Network Attached Storage. So, in a sense, it's any device connected to your network that happens to provide storage to some of the other devices connected to your network. It doesn't have to be a dedicated box. It can be. It doesn't have to be anything other than an old PC. Honestly, NAS devices themselves, whether they're a dedicated box sold as a network-attached storage device or something else, are really nothing more than, I'll call it, a stripped-down PC. By that I mean they often don't have an interface for a keyboard or a mouse or video. They're simply something you put on your network, access across your network, configure across your network, and then they make a bunch of disk space available on your local network. What's interesting about them is that most of them are in fact PC-based. Even without the keyboard and the screen. They're running, typically, a version of Linux, either a generic version of Linux, like I do, which I'll talk about in a minute, or they're running a dedicated version of a Linux variant whose job it is to be network-attached storage and to do that job as most efficient as possible. Now, there are dedicated NAS devices. You can buy them online. They typically will actually have multiple hard disks, usually in a removable bay, so that you can replace them in real time if need be, without necessarily even powering down or disconnecting the NAS. They tend to use RAID. Now, what's neat about these devices is that they are optimized for a couple of things. They're optimized for speed and resiliency. So, for example, if you have a 4-drive NAS, it may only look like there are 3 drives or the equivalent storage of 3 drives. But what that means is that the RAID array that's being used is providing you with a fair amount of redundancy and optimized for speed. So what happens is if one of the drives fails, which happens, you can actually replace the drive in real time, and the NAS using RAID will then rebuild whatever needs to be done on that drive. What's interesting about this is, like I said, it's resilient to disk failure, but it's also tends to be faster as long as you're connected to a fast enough network to make that speed apparent to the other machines on your network. Now, that's a NAS device. That's a dedicated NAS device, and you could run out there and you can buy those. I used to have one for a very long time. It was kind of nice. It was basically just disk space on my network. That's what a NAS is. What's interesting about this, though, is that, like I said, most NAS devices at their core are really just dedicated task PCs. Well, couldn't you just use a PC? And the answer, of course, is a resounding yes. There are 2 approaches to this. One is that you take an older PC, or any PC actually, and run on it NAS software. Now, there used to be something called FreeNAS that has transitioned into something called TrueNAS Core, which is still free. It is a Linux variant, essentially, that you would install on a PC that would allow you to configure that PC to act as a dedicated NAS device. It tends to run very much like some of the other dedicated NAS devices that you might be able to purchase, but instead allows you to repurpose an older PC to perform that specific task. I used it for a while. I don't anymore. I much prefer, and now actually use, a third solution. And that is simply, I run Linux on a PC. in my basement. And in that configuration, I have a bunch of external drives. They are all shared using traditional file sharing to my local network and are accessible to all of my PCs. That's exactly like a NAS. But instead of using dedicated NAS software or even a dedicated NAS specific device, I've just got an old PC with a bunch of disks connected to it, acting like a NAS. As I record this, it has something like 10 or 11 external USB hard drives that are all shared for easy access to all of the other PCs on my network. That's a NAS. It's not a NAS-specific device. It is a generic Ubuntu Linux box, but it's simply using file sharing to make all of these external drives available on my local area network. So, what should you do? What do you need? Well, there are a couple of pros and cons to the scenarios that I've just outlined. The biggest one is that when you've got a dedicated NAS device, you have this opportunity to actually use RAID. RAID is not backup, but it can make things faster, and it does make the hard disks somewhat more resilient to failure. Like I said, if a hard disk fails in a RAID array, you simply pull out the drive, replace it with something new, and the RAID array basically handles making sure that everything continues to run without interruption. On the other hand, if you're using an older PC, if you've got an old PC lying around, it's a great opportunity to just set it up and do the NAS-like things. The downside, of course, is that you probably won't have RAID abilities on that device. You may not need it. For my device with my 10 or 11 external hard drives, yeah, there's no RAID. That's not the point. The point is to provide a lot of storage to my system, to my local area network, simply by reusing an old PC and a bunch of old hard drives. Welcome to my basement. I wanted to show you the NAS device that I have set up that I was talking about in the previous video and on the website. First of all, let me show you some of what's going on in my basement. I suspect that everybody has one of these. That is, of course, the collection of power supplies that have accumulated over the years as things have gone out of use. Power supplies, basically, they last forever, and we have a really, really hard time getting rid of them. So what you're looking at here is, in fact, my NAS. On the left-hand side is the 10-bay USB external drive. That bay is full of SATA drives. It's a great way to repurpose old drives. And in fact, here's one I can show you. This is an older 1 terabyte SATA drive. In that bay, I have 10 separate drives, ranging from 1 to 5 terabytes in there. You'll notice that next to it, there is in fact a another external drive. I believe that's a 8 terabyte external drive. But the bottom line here is that this is a great way to reuse old drives that have come from old computers. Some of the drives in there actually came from an old NAS that I used to use a long time ago. It's really, really useful. Now, I'm not saying that you need to have a 10-drive external bay. I mean, that's me being me. There's a 5-bay version of this, and there are other alternatives as well. But it turned out to be a really useful and really stable way of reusing a bunch of drives. Now, what's important to realize here is that while this looks like, or very similar to, many of the RAID arrays you might see, this is not a RAID device. It is nothing more than 10 external drives, and that's exactly how it appears once it's connected to the computer. So there are 10 external drives there. There's the 11th external drive there between that. That's an old HP computer. That one connection you see on the right-hand side on its front, that's a USB-C connection, and that is the single connection to which all 10 of those external drives are connected. Then obviously off to the left, off to the right here, I've got the screen. That is nothing more than Linux.
I'm actually running Ubuntu Linux Server, so it doesn't even have a graphical user interface. But this is a very, very useful way of reusing or preserving an old piece of hardware, basically extending its life well beyond what would normally take. In this case, this is an older HP machine. And again, this is what my so-called NAS looks like. It's not a dedicated NAS device. I could do whatever I want with this machine, but it is, the way I've implemented it, a NAS.
So my bottom line to you is, unless you have specific needs for something that is RAID tolerant, in other words, error tolerant and supposedly faster than just having some external drives on a PC, sure, consider a standalone dedicated NAS device. But in reality, creating your own NAS out of an old PC running either Linux or Windows is actually a very, very reasonable approach to extending the usable life of older PCs and some of those older external hard drives you might have lying around. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/98349. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.